Tinkercad dropped a brand new feature for the sketch tool. I'm going to show it to you, so let's get cracking. Friends, this is Tinkercad. You can find it at tinkercad.com. I always choose sign in with Google. When you create designs, they are saved to the cloud. This is one that I'm working on right now. I'm going to show you the new feature inside it. So I am creating a 65K thank you because the channel just reached that. Tinkercad designer Hamster Build has a fun community scrapbook. I thought my 65K thank you would fit, so I'm going to lump these together. Of course, thanks to everybody that supports the channel. This is just fun stuff using the custom font tool. If you've never used it, I've got a tutorial I'll placed up here. And then also I threw in a canvas circle text. I'll put a link to that project as well. This heart is built into the system. It's called Cute Heart. You can search for it right over here. And then right now I'm going to show you the brand new feature. We're going to bounce to basic shapes. We're going to grab the sketch tool. I'm going to set it right here on a 20 by 20 grid. That way it lines up with its center point in the grid lines. And then this works like this. We can do straight lines or we can do curves. You can press the number 2 to switch between them. Then you can click close to your shape and you can trace it. Since I did the curve, I can click, hold, and bend so that it gets close to the system. I don't need to be perfect because I can edit it when I'm done. Notice that one just landed nice. This one, I'm going to click and twist. I'm going to come down here to the bottom, click. This is going to be a tough corner, or actually that worked out pretty smooth. And I'm going to click. I will let you know that fewer points usually adds to a smoother curve. Click and twist, click and twist. Just getting it closed, and I'm going to just finish it. So that's the start of the project, but now I can double click and I can edit it. Now if you double click, it auto lines it. If you double click again, it auto smooths it. I don't think I want either of those, so I'm going to do Control Z to get back to what I had done. And now I'm just going to modify these. If I click on a single piece, right now that's pretty straight, but I can grab the handle and move it to where I wanted it to be. You can grab the whole part and move it. If you ever don't like what you did, just do Control Z. I'm going to modify these. Notice they are solid lines. That means they are what are called smooth curves. If you have something fancy where you need to break it, you can hit number 3 and you get the dotted lines for the broken curves. I had it all selected, so they all broke. I'm going to do Control Z and undo that. And if I click just on this point and hit the number 3, now I've got a broken curve so I can make that go exactly how I want. Now I don't need to be perfect. I just want to get it close. And I'm also going to move it a little bit outside the shape. I want to just be close to it because I'm going to show you a brand new feature Tinkercad just enabled. If I click out here to go back to the pen mode, I can now click on this. And we have a brand new tool called Stroke Settings. If you enable it, it now is just doing the outside of the shape. Line width 2. We've got different choices like inside, outside, and center. I think I want that one to actually be center. That way it rides the thing I traced pretty darn well. Notice it doesn't quite fit down here, so I'll fix that in a minute. We could also change the corners from sharp to round, depending on how you want it to look. I'm going to click on my line. Notice you have to click the edge now to get to it. I'm going to fix this part down here. Notice we can go back in and edit so it matches how we want it to go. Bang. Click out here and finish the sketch. I'm going to real quickly add a color to it. Let's click on custom. Come out here, get into those reds, and drive it to wherever you want. Bang, we've got the colors light. I do not like how this turned out though, so let's go back here and double click and smooth that corner. Notice if I zoom in, you can see that has a bad joint to it. If I double click on the blue lines, we can tweak that and adjust it. I'm going to switch it back to number 2. Notice I'm on the dot. There's my smooth line, and I'm going to just move the dot to where it works. I think that looks a lot better. Did not mess up anything else. Let's hit finish sketch. And that, my friends, is pretty darn awesome. As you can see, I've added some Tinkercad notes. These are just ways to find me and then also fun projects that you might want to try out. Of course, I do want to say thank you to Hamster Build for the projects. I want to say thanks to all of you for supporting the channel. And of course, I want to say thank you to my supporters via YouTube memberships. There are three different levels of support. You can get early access to videos for as low as $5 a month. I also want to say thanks to everybody supporting me via Patreon. Love how that group is growing. There is a free messaging board. You really need to check it out. You can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button and share a video, add a comment down below or click subscribe, you're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.